pain, wealth, and supplication. This is as the truth of the Quran has shown, and the proofs in the noble Sunnah. So provide good actions to this Ummah for Allah's sake, and give forth from yourselves from the wealth that Allah has provided that will lead to the great bliss. So one of the greatest means for attaining victory is to turn to Allah the Almighty with sincerity, humility, and supplication, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us. And when they advanced to meet Jalut, Goliath, and his forces, they invoked, "Our Lord, pour forth on us patience, and set firm our feet, and make us victorious over the disbelieving people." So the result was Allah's statement. So they routed them by Allah's leave, and Dawood, David, killed Jalut, Goliath.
ومن أدعية المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم في الغزوات: اللهم منزل الكتاب، سريع الحساب، مجري السحاب، هازم الأحزاب، اللهم اهزمهم وانصرهم، اللهم اهزمهم وزلزلهم وانصرنا عليهم، رواه مسلم.
From the supplications of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that he made in the battles, he said, "O Allah, the revealer of the book, the one quick to reckon, the one who causes the clouds to flow, the vanquisher over the groups. O Allah, defeat them and shake the earth beneath them and make us victorious over them." This hadith was related by Muslim.
وَكَانَ يَقُولُ فِي حَالِ الْتِقَاءِ الصَّفَّيْنِ اللَّهُمَّ أَنْتَ أَضُدِي وَأَنْتَ نَصِيرِي بِكَ أَجُولْ وَبِكَ أَصُولْ وَبِكَ أُقَاتِلْ.
And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say, whilst in midst of battle, "O Allah, you are my helper, you are my victor. By you I go and by you I return, and by you I fight."
إخوة الإسلام، الرسالة الثالثة على الأمة جميعا: الحذر من المعاصي كلها، والبعد عن المناهي جميعها. فلقد فتحت علينا أبواب كل شر، ولقد أغلقت عنا أبواب كل نصر، بها تحل الكوارث وتنزل المذلات وينتصر الأعداء وتضعف القدرة. أولما أصابتكم مصيبة قد أصبتم مثليها قلتم أنى هذا؟ قل هو من عند أنفسكم. وما أصابكم من مصيبة فبما كسبت أيديكم، ويعفو عن كثير. ورسولنا صلى الله عليه وسلم يحدثنا عن شأننا اليوم بقوله: وجعل الذلة والصغار على من خالف أمري، حديث صحيح.
O Muslim brothers, the third message to the whole Ummah is a warning against all sins, and to keep away from the sins and the places where sins are committed. For verily all the doors of evil have been opened against us. All the doors of help have been shut to us. This is what allows these disasters to beset us. And the mathulat is the punishments to descend. And the enemies become victorious and our ability is therefore weakened. As Allah says in the Quran, "What is the matter with you when a single disaster smites you? Although you smote your enemies with one twice as great, you say, 'From where does this come to us?' Say to them, 'It is from yourselves, because of your evil deeds.'" And Allah says, "And whatever of misfortune befalls you, it is because of what your hands have earned, and He pardons much." The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam narrated to us about our condition today in his saying, "Humiliation and insignificance has been put over whomsoever opposes my affair." This is an authentic hadith.
الرسالة الرابعة: الحذر، الحذر من مكائد الكافرين ومن موالاتهم ومحبتهم. فربنا جل وعلا يقول: لا يتخذ المؤمنون الكافرين أولياء من دون المؤمنين، ومن يفعل ذلك فليس من الله في شيء. وما ضاعت الأندلس إلا بأسباب أعظمها ضياع عقيدة الولاء والبراء، والاستعداء على المسلمين بالأعداء الحاقدين وعقد العهود والأحلاف معهم ضد المسلمين تحقيقا للمصالح الذاتية. واقرأوا التاريخ جيدا.
The fourth message is a warning against the plots of the disbelievers and from taking them as protectors and loving them. Allah the Most High says, let not the believers take the disbelievers as awliya, helpers instead of the believers. And whoever does that will never be helped by Allah in any way. Andalus was not lost except due to certain reasons. The greatest reason being the Muslim population losing their belief in the wala and bara, which is loving and hating for Allah's sake alone. The Muslims had sought nearness to the hate-filled enemies by making agreements and pacts with them. Making agreements and pacts with them against other Muslims for personal gains. Read the history books to learn more.
الرسالة الخامسة أن الرابطة الحقيقية للأمة يجب أن تكون كلمة التوحيد ومضامين السنة الصحيحة فإحلال الشعارات القومية الزائفة والحزبيات المقيتة محلها أخطر شيء على الأمة وأعظم مرض في جسدها. واسألوا حرب عام 48 وحرب عام 76 وحرب 67 اسألوا واقرأوا ذلك جيدا.
The fifth message, that the true bond between the Ummah must be one that is based upon the statement of Tawheed and the contents of the correct Sunnah. Displaying bogus nationalistic slogans and having different groups, this is the most dangerous issue facing the Ummah. It is the greatest ailment in its body. Look at the war of 1948 or the war of 1967 and ask around. Ask around, look at what happened in both those times.
لن تفلح أمة الإسلام عربا وعجما إلا حينما يكون منهجها واحدا هو الإسلام وقائدها هو رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بسيرته الصحيحة. الذين آمنوا يقاتلون في سبيل الله والذين كفروا يقاتلون في سبيل الطاغوت. الله جل وعلا يخبرنا أيضا ثم جعلناك على شريعة من الأمر فاتبعها ولا تتبع أهواء الذين لا يعلمون. أمة الإسلام إن أضر شيء على الأمة اختلاف القلوب وتفرق الصف فهو أعظم الأسباب في القضاء على كيان الأمة الإسلامية لاستلزامه الفشل وذهاب القوة والدولة. ألم يقل الله جل وعلا وأطيعوا الله ورسوله ولا تنازعوا فتفشلوا وتذهب ريحكم واصبروا. ألا فلتمحى الفواصل والحواجز برابطة الإسلام الجامع والعقيدة الرابطة بين القلوب والنفوس على حد قول خالقنا جل وعلا واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا.
The Islamic nation will never be successful. The Arab and non-Arab Islamic Ummah can never succeed except when their manhaj methodology is one, when it is based upon Islam and its leader is Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, by way of the people following his authentic seerah biography. As Allah says, and those who believe fight in Allah's way, and those who disbelieve fight in the way of the taghut, the false gods. Allah also informs us, then we have put on you, O Muhammad, on a plain way of our commandment. So follow you that, and follow not the desires of those who know not. O Muslim nation, the most harmful thing upon the Ummah is the differing of the hearts and the splitting of the ranks. This is one of the greatest issues causing the overcoming of the Islamic leadership.